wake up. Hey there, Stefan. I'm your conscience. Act upon my words, and everything will work out fine. You have to wake up or you're going to be late for work. Quick, let's head downtown. You don't have much time. To read the info signs, approach them and press triangle. Just ahead is a milestone. If you light it with a torch, you'll be able to restart there in case you slip up during a level. Did it, Stefan. Let's pick up the pace a bit more, or you'll surely be late. To get over to the church hall, we have to climb up the steeple. Have faith in your running and walking jumps, and you'll make it. Down this hill is the fastest route for us to take, Stefan. You won't have much control going down it, so listen to my command to jump to avoid things in your path. Jump! Jump! Hey, there's your skateboard, Stefan. Jump on it, and you'll easily make it to work on time.
Woo!
You've reached the end of the concrete, Stefan. Hop off your skateboard. Looks like the key to control the elevator is missing. We need that key to make it down to the job site. It has to be around here somewhere. That looks like a key we can use for that elevator, Stefan. Let's try it out so that you can make it down into the mines to start up your shift. It sounds like they've already started working, Stefan. As you make your way through the tunnels, be careful around some of the drilling that is being done. I think it's safe to say that you made it on time, Stefan. Let's head down further into the tunnels to the right and start your work there.
Stefan equipped himself with a light and a hard hat as he descended further into the tunnels of dirt and debris. He wasn't alone. He could hear the clanging of work up ahead, as well as his conscience. He had shown perseverance in getting to work on his own, and this fortitude would lead him to consistently give his all in everything he focused on. Little did he know how far he would push these limits.
Looks like a note for you, Stefan. The boss wants you to grab a jackhammer from storage and start digging up coal at the end of this tunnel. You know very well that the storage shed is locked at all times. We'll have to explore around for the key to unlock it. Control panel hanging from the side of this crane to move its arm. Moving the arm could help us sift through this area better to find that key. flipping the switch. Press try. That's not the key to the storage shed, but it looks like something we might be able to use to get closer to. Stefan?
Thank you.
Crouch in front of that ledge. Let's go back and take a look at where that last boulder might have rolled to, Stefan. That's the key to the storage shed. Great work, Stefan. Now we can head over to the storage shed and get that jackhammer. Jackhammer's all ready to go, Stefan. Let's work our way through the tunnel ahead and see if we can find some coal to pick up. Careful though, it looks dark up ahead. Stefan, your hard hat! Now you're going to have to be even more cautious without any light. Stay alert. Oh, this is getting pretty risky. The next jump looks like a long one. Stay back a bit until you can see the ledge.
After recovering his equipment and returning to the surface, Stefan told the workers about the coal he had found. Doing this made him feel accomplished, and that he was contributing to the team. However, to his dismay, the workers laughed hysterically.
That ain't coal back in there, boy. Just some accumulation of exhaust fumes and slag dust. We had our vehicles digging around back in them bowels months ago.
And so the time passed on with the cycle of Stefan doing what he could to make it by as an accomplished coal miner. Every day, he traveled back and forth from the heights of Gojefa to the depths, going above and beyond to feel good enough for his job. The physical and mental stress he inflicted on himself looped endlessly. With each iteration, it sheared off a tiny strand of his physical and emotional health. Eventually, these strands were swallowed up by a dark storm that circled the land he walked on. From within it, three pestilences were summoned over the life of Stefan. A pestilence of anxiety, a pestilence of rage, and a pestilence of sadness. They would each pry off a piece of Stefan and hold them ransom, leaving him in a state of both turmoil and nothingness.
is outweighing me. If you can lighten the load of it, that should bring my crate down. Then I should be able to escape. Here comes the first lightning orb. Try to avoid it as long as you can. Second orb is coming after you now. Hang in there. The last orb, Stefan. If you survive this one, I should be able to break free. You did it, Stefan. Now let's find a way off this train. Stefan, wake up. You must have had an intense nightmare. You were shaking tremendously. I can already tell you won't be able to fall back asleep. But at least you rested for most of the afternoon into this evening. With all of the anxiety that you've had lately, nothing will help your mind better than a walk. Hey, let's head out to the woods behind your house, Stefan. I know these are hard times for you now, and that you'll do everything to get back to how you were before. You've always put your love to the extreme, Stefan. I just hope you won't obsess over your faults while trying to get all your pieces back together. Life is too short to dwell on your imperfections. seem troubled. Stefan?
And yet another fall for Stefan. He stared at his reflection in the water at the bottom of a dark pit. As he locked his eyes on the imperfections he was trying to fix, a flaring desire started to bloom from within him. He was determined to get out of this pit and to put his pieces back together. Through the will to overcome his struggles, Stefan discovered that his potential was only limited by negative thoughts. Clearing his head allowed him to ascend beyond his physical expectations.
Almost completely down. There's a campsite just up over this small hill, Stefan. Let's head over there and try to find a source of light before it gets too dark. storm is approaching. Hurry, let's get some shelter inside that windmill before it swallows us up. We should be safe in here. Let's just try to relax for the time being. Stefan, are you okay? Stefan, your anxiety is taking you over again. You need to get a hold of yourself. You can do this. Take control of this pestilence, as only you have the ability to put it to rest.
Pestilence gave into a recession, leaving behind a set of segments to piece back onto Stefan. Stefan proved to himself that he could patch himself up. With his growing vitality and the devotion to gain back his past self, he steadied himself for the two remaining pieces.
Stefan, you're pacing around the house again? You've been stuck inside of your head for way too long now, and you're going to end up scorching yourself from the inside out. Why don't you take a break from yourself and try to socialize a little bit more? I think there's supposed to be a huge gathering at the Faros Follies downtown this evening. Why don't you head on down to the club and let out some steam on the dance floor? Meeting some new faces should... What's the matter, Stefan? Are you okay? Stefan, why are you in such a hurry? I didn't realize you'd be that excited to get bought downtown tonight. Maybe they'll have a competition for the best dancer. That would surely make a name for yourself. Feels like deja vu, doesn't it, Stefan? At least the weather is supposed to hold up nicely tonight. Are you hanging in there alright, Stefan? Even with as much moving as you've done so far, you still seem restless. You've got to release that inner fury. Holding on to anything for too long will eventually tear you from the inside out. Slow down. You've got to calm yourself. We've got some time left before the club opens. In the meantime, let's venture around town for a bit. Thank you.
Stefan realized yet another vulnerability by being boxed into a corner by his inner fury. He had barely escaped, and he knew that this wouldn't be the last encounter with it. By focusing deep into his potential, he acquired another ability that would help him in overcoming this pestilence.
Looks like the Theros Follies is still closed. Let's check out the park ahead, and then come back here once it gets darker. What a great night to be here. This place is jumping. Stefan, are you doing all right? It looks like your inner fury is rearing its head again. Well, it's time for you to extinguish it. Thank you.
finally submitted to the efforts of Stefan, patching up his next missing piece. One segment remained, and was the last thing Stefan believed he needed to return to the being he was years ago.
When did the circus roll into town?
Yeah, really? They must take a big liking to square-brained ballerinas like you.
Yes, let the poor little boy go. It's probably way past his bedtime anyway.
Stefan, you're going to end up drowning yourself in your own self-hatred if you continue to take things personally. Listen to me. Forget the opinion. Ignore them and you will be completely wrong.
The distraction Stefan placed in his head made him unable to understand his conscience. Unaware of his surroundings and now lacking his motivation, he trudged forward through the thick murk of his mind.
They must take a big liking to square-brained ballerinas like you.
But the poor little boy girl is probably way past his bedtime anyway.
Thank you. Stefan. Stefan, come to your senses. Listen to me. You need to get all of this negativity out of your head. Wandering around aimlessly isn't going to help either. How many times do I have to tell you that you can't be bogged down by all of these faults in your life? You're losing love for yourself, and you need to give this love back to yourself and to the world around you. Come on, let's get some motivation back in you and quickly find some shelter around here. Skunk? Let's find somewhere else to stay. These buildings look like they're all going to collapse at any second. We'd best not stay in any of these. not stand any of these. Anywhere that you're going to have to crouch through isn't good either. This place looks dangerous anyway. More buildings that look like they're going to collapse any second. It's too bad that the vehicle back there is locked. Up ahead is the base of an old satellite tower. It's not in the best shape, but it has a large enough cover to keep the rain out. Let's check it out. Stefan, what are you doing? It's much safer to stay down here and wait for the storm to stop. Why are you doing this, Stefan? You're risking your life climbing up this tower. Did you hear me, Stefan? Get out of your head and listen to me. You're pushing yourself over the edge of sanity doing this. You're too far gone now. You've made up your mind what you want, Stefan. It's hopeless to even try with words anymore. Thank you. I'm sorry, but I had to do this, Stefan.
Stefan lost all hope. He felt abandoned. His own conscience had betrayed him. He spent so many years focusing only on himself, and it seemed like he would never be who he once was ever again. He had nothing to show for everything he had done for so long. But this was exactly what his conscience warned him about throughout his journey. It's what he wanted Stefan to understand, and the only way of doing so would be to stop him in his tracks. Being able to focus on improving yourself is important in life, but it was the only thing Stefan thought about. He obsessed over it, and by continuously obsessing over it, he missed out on so many other things in life, holding back from giving and receiving love in the world. This was the moment Stefan needed. His conscience's actions showed Stefan everything he had to see to understand the ramifications he would run into if he achieved everything he wanted. His spirit was strong, his intentions were good, but his approach was wrong, and it would lead to personal demise down the road. Life is to be enjoyed, and not made to be constantly trying to fix everything in it. Stefan now realized that through his failed efforts, he had to share his experiences with the people of the world and help them love themselves for who they are. He now knew that it was love in the world, both internally and externally, that would ultimately put an end to the struggles of Stefan.
Thank you.
Hey there. My name is Clint Ecker, and I'm the creator behind the Struggles of Stefan. I really appreciate your persistence in completing the game and allowing me to share the message of the story with you. Again, I appreciate the support so much, and I hope you enjoyed the game.